Right, so we are going to have a look now at something called functions. And functions are really, really useful for the programmer because it saves you repeating lots and lots of code. Okay, now I've written a really great poem just here, and it's just a series of print statements. And you can see that it prints out into the shell. Okay, now let's say I wanted to repeat this poem lots of times. Okay, now the obvious thing to do is to copy it and paste it, okay, lots of times like that, and when I run the program it will repeat. Okay, but as a programmer, what we want to do is we want to make our code as efficient as possible. We want to use the least amount of lines that we can to make the program work. So what we can do is use a function. Okay, now what I'm going to do, I'm just going to cut this set of print statements, and up the top here we'll just ignore all this stuff I've commented out. I'm going to create a function, and to do that in Python you type the word def and then you give the function a name, a bit like a variable. Again, you can give it any name as long as it's not a command word, and I'm going to do two brackets and a colon. Okay, and you can see there it's indented away from the side automatically. Okay, and if I just go paste, all right, I'm just going to indent these other lines so it lines up with this first line here. And to do that, just use your tab key on the keyboard, just press that once and that will shift everything across. Okay, so what we have is when we run this function, and I'll show you how to run the function shortly, it will run anything inside it. And by inside it, what I mean is anything indented. Okay, so if that bit line of code is indented, it will run inside the function. Okay, for example, if I did that, those three lines would run, but not this one. Okay, so indentation in Python, and we'll look at that later, is very important. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to press F5 now and we'll see what happens. Okay, absolutely nothing. Okay, which is actually what we wanted, because I haven't actually what we call called the function. So I've written the function, but I haven't told the computer when to run it. So to do that, if we go down and we go unindent, so we use the backspace to bring it back to the side here, and if I just write the word poem and two brackets, okay, just like that. So what that does, that calls the function. All right, so if I run now, what should happen is it should print my function. Okay, cool. Now let's say I wanted it twice. What do you think I would do? Well, maybe just do this. Okay, there we go, it's done it twice. We could do something really fancy here. So that's slightly tongue-in-cheek. We could just add a space between the two functions. There we go. Okay. So what you can do is you can turn sections of your programs into functions and call them several times. So have a go at maybe doing something like this yourself. And then you could even turn our number adding program that we did in our last video, you could turn that into a function and run it as well. You could even turn the input statement we did in the variables video, the input video, into a function as well. So have a go, have a little play with functions, and see how you get on.